Hey everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Avedon the Black Fortress. Today we're trying to find Sevelin, who just took off, complained that no one's gonna help him without asking for help. Like, just ask me, guy, I'm gonna help you. It's fine. I've reached the White Plains, a desolate remote region in the southern claw. Something in the sand makes it pale and chalky. The hard cacti that infest most of this region can grow here, very little else can, and yet the region's far from unsettled. You see the tracks of the occasional predator, enjoying the ability to hunt far from the pack's hunters. There's also leading to the south, a path here. There are boot prints and wagon tracks. Perhaps that is where Sevelin went. Oh, also, you may be thinking, oh, your voice sounds different today. Yeah, it kind of does. My throat is a little raw because I went to, at work we had some activity for, you know, team spirit and whatnot, and it was throwing axes, and the place was a little loud, so I kept having to talk rather loud. It was loud insofar as they had some metal or hard music playing at all times. But yeah, that was a thing we did, but point being, got my throat raw because I was talking to... Alright, it's just fire, I'm stupid. But yeah, that was loud music, so I was talking loud, so my throat is feeling it. It's fine, though, don't worry about it. Oh, there we go. I'm not about to fight every single goddamn salamander. I might as well. Because that's a dead end, right? No, you know what? No. Let's go get Sevelin. We can do that with Sevelin in tow. It's gonna be better than having Shima. Nothing against you, Shima. You're just rather ill-equipped. Behind you, you hear someone shout angry obscenity. Someone pushed aside a large dead cacti, revealing a concealed pathway. A thorn in his hand caused him to spoil much of the surprise of the attack. Several brigands pushed their way out of the thicket. They must have seen you pass and decided that you were a tempting target. They're kind of idiots, then. Yeah, they're pretty much kind of idiots. Spray! And pray. Well, it did pretty good, I guess. Yeah, that's all the area of effect I'm gonna use. That's all the area of effect I'm gonna need, really. He dropped a lot of stuff. That cannot be the brigands that actually bested, what's-his-face Sevelin. I don't think it can be, mainly because the leader we've heard so much about that I've already forgotten his name is not here, as far as I know. Oh, nice crit. I don't think I kill her without the crit. Excuse me? You're going after the mage? What are you, rude? Well, I mean, they're brigands. I guess they are rude at that, but yeah, I'm just being silly. Alright. The silver necklace, money. Most of this is money. Well, that's what I expected, but you know, had to check. Oh, wait. Hello. You are? Excuse me? You do not exist. Okay. Not yet. A cultist! What does he worship? I wonder. Let's have the mages focus on him, maybe. Oh, he has some HP to him. Oh, darkness. I should be able to finish him. Yeah. I don't know if I do it without a... Oh. Battle Frenzy. I did not... I would have forgotten that you could do that. Get frenzied by getting hit. Maybe I should keep Shima. I don't know. With the... what enemy? Oh, there was a wolf there. I don't care. Maybe I should keep Shima with the understanding that since I'm playing on easy difficulty, well, not easy, actually it's normal, but it's easy for the game's sake, if I'm gonna be playing on a difficulty that is easy without being called easy, maybe it's worth it just to have more damage, because we expect to just crush everything, and we're gonna crush it faster with him. It's a thought. But then again, I just don't want to run into something I can't handle. I don't know. I don't know, really. The pathway curves around a small oasis. Animals from all over the area come here to drink. Their tracks are everywhere, extending to the water and then back into the thickets. To the east, you see a small pack of wolves resting near the water. That must be the side favored by predators. On the west side, you see a few sickly cows. A wolf occasionally and half-heartedly crosses sides to snarl at a potential prey. Sure. Are you snarling, wolf? Probably. That's what the event said you were doing. Oh man! That's a miss. Not a very good hit. Oh well. A stone! Goodness me. Excuse me. A rock! Is that a hellhound? That is a hellhound. Interesting. Is the cow following me? What do you want from me? The salamander and corrupted hellhounds, god damn it. Now I gotta use my bow. That was kinda weak. Well, the three of them can kill things even. Oh, I never leveled her up. In my mind, I already did, but I had canceled it because someone was coming. I forgot about that, though. I mean, damn, alright. I guess I'll level her up soon enough. Excuse me? You don't do that. You don't just do that. Alright. Enough. Anything underground? No. What do you do? A bit more intelligence, I suppose. Oh, I can get three on that. My lizard will have the ability to summon a cloud of fire. Nice. Looking forward to six now. I can already get it. Well, I mean, okay, I can get it in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 points, 5 levels. Yeah, that's far away, actually. What level are we? 23? You get the last specialization at 25. Oh, we're further ahead than I thought. If you expect, like, utility, I expect, like, level 25 to come to be timed, like, late mid-game or early end-game, I guess. That's how I would see it. Maybe this game has it really early, or maybe I'm further ahead in the game than I thought I was. Either one's a possibility. It's blind, so I wouldn't know. Just something to think about. We're kind of high level, although we're only starting to get the we are only starting to get the loyalty missions. Then again, I don't know if I'm going to get a mission for. Oh, there's more. And I cannot. And combat. I don't know if I'm gonna get a mission with Natalie and even Shima, because I don't really use them, right? Then again, maybe we will, and it's just gonna be a matter of I don't feel like doing it, right? Okay, you're gonna focus on these, because she can't. In fact, Shima should as well focus on these. If he can. He can't, but if he can, you know what? He can. He just throws things at him. There you go. Nice. Good for you. Still can't. Work your way down there, I guess. Oh, well, how nice of you. There we go. Another one bites the dust, and of course, I am once again last to actually get my level up. I don't know why that is. A clay break? What is it doing here? whatever. So you just got dexterity. You're getting endurance in two levels. I'm gonna do this. What next? Interesting. I'm gonna go get level three of this real quick. Then we're gonna focus on other things. Yeah, because I'm reaching the point where I get really high abilities. I don't know if we're close to the end of the game or not. I don't feel like we're close to the end of the game. That's just what's weirding me out a little. Growth is not. It's going to slow down, I feel, a little, because we're not gonna get those power spikes as much. Wait, those are friendly. What is this? Really, you've been following ends at a small settlement. It's a small cluster of buildings deep in the wastes, far too small to be considered a town. A few guards hide behind the palisade. They aren't pack soldiers. Their armor is crude, and their weapons are bent and dirty. And yet, it's not a brigand settlement either. They don't move to attack or otherwise hinder you when you approach. A sign by the entrance says "Deathbound Colony." Perhaps someone here can tell you what that means, and with luck, where Sevelin went. Yeah, hopefully. Lots of hands about. Does that mean you've seen a hand recently? Would love to hear all about that, if you don't mind. Meanwhile, I'm just gonna map your thing out, just in case I have to, I don't know. No actual reason, actually. I just feel like mapping it. Okay, fine, I'm gonna talk to you. What are you? There's a merchant sitting in this low smoky fire, roasting a haunch of some animal or other. It almost smells delicious. She seems surprised to see you. Well, it's. You're ahead, aren't you? Another one. I don't see what has made the White Plains so terribly important in the eyes of the Pact, but I would be glad to have customers with money. You don't usually get those, do you? Considering the name of the place, Deathbound, I guess the people that come here don't really have money. They probably have debt. Lack of money. Debt more than they have money. I'm late. Yelisa, I would be happy to trade with you. What is this place? This place? It's for the debt-bound, people who owe more money than they can pay. The Stone Code gives them two choices: servitude or exile in miserable little pits like this one. Oh, well, interesting. I want to know more. Talk to Mert. He's sort of the leader here. I don't talk about law if I can help it. Law? There's such a thing as law here? Okay. Well, I mean, I think I saw the code, although the Stone Code isn't supposed to be in minor regions. It's on my route. It's a safe place to stop. Sometimes they buy things, not enough to go out of my way for, but if I'm here. They don't normally have it. Not here. This law is poor, but that doesn't stop them from buying a few things. Tools, weapons. They buy weapons? Yes, that's one of the reasons I come here. No matter how useless or banged up a blade is, I can always get a few coins for it here. Helps them keep the predators at bay. Well, it would, I suppose. There are probably better ways, like building the fence. Also, I guess they did that too. Any sort, they use them to make crafts or to earn money clearing back the cacti for the towns. Hell, they hope to earn enough money to pay off their debts and go home. Sometimes they even succeed. How is it that they can make more money here than they could in their previous life? That seems silly. I'm looking for a hand. He's here, makes all the debt-bound good and nervous. He does. He's in one of the halls. I don't know which one. Ah, useful. What do you sell? Lockpicks, that's nice. Elixir of recoveries are really good. Exorbitant. Well, what do you want? This is really good. I guess I could sell her the garbage. You don't get to keep any of that, or that for that matter. One of the halls. Mert's Hall. That might be one of the halls. Well, I mean, obviously it's one of the halls. I mean, that might be the hall I'm looking for. Are there more walls? I mean, halls? Walls, certainly. This town is well surrounded by cacti. Alright, so three possible buildings, and you could not remember which one he's in. I guess she's not here to spy on him or anything. Yeah, I don't want to speak to you, though. Alright, let's try another one. Sevelin, what are you doing here? So, Dirty Hall has enough room for well over a dozen of deadbound to live here, drying out of the sun. However, there's only one man here, sitting on a filthy pallet with his back to you. Everyone else has left. When you get close, he looks over his shoulder at you. His face lights up. Zevlin jumps to his feet and grabs your hand. I am not sure what to say. I am glad you're here, Simplicity. Pleased and ashamed as well. So, where is everyone else? They fled. They avoid me wherever I go. They are a beaten, ashamed people. The gaze of Avedon burns too hot for them. So, what is this place? It is a colony of the debt-bound, people of the Claw who owe money and cannot repay it. The Stone Code gives them a choice. They can flee to settlements like this, or they can enter harsh servitude. They are given a choice. It is the justice of the code.
Sure.
Justice. Depends on how the debt was accrued, I suppose. I tracked Cahill to here. It took cunning, bribery, and harsh questioning, but I found him. He is nearby. And yet, that is as close as I have come. He is here. I can smell him. And yet, the people here refuse to give me the final directions I need. Why won't they help you? Because they fear retribution, I think. They are terrified of that Cahill will crush them if they speak with Avedon, and perhaps they are correct in this. If we fail, they are. If we don't, they're gonna be fine. Why are they scared of you? They feel that Avedon is looking for any excuse to crush them, as if Avedon cares a whit for these wretches. Really it doesn't. They are never going to be a threat to us, I don't think. They might do something silly like sell weapons to wretches, which are not that far away. And that's one of the few cases where we would take an interest, maybe, but otherwise, I don't care, indeed. I will hunt down Cahill, the Claw, they call him. I have sworn vengeance on him. Why do you think he's here? Do not ask me the favors I had to call you and the harsh steps I had to take. From them, I learned that he was in this area. Questioning the debt-bound here, seeing the fear in their eyes, I know that I am close. This is the place, but we must act before he flees. So you still want to hunt him? He and his brigands attacked me and my fellow hands when we were on patrol. Only I survived. For this he must pay. If Avedon cannot punish such a crime, it can do nothing. And yet I can't hunt him down alone. Simplicity, will you help me? Shima nods. Well, good of you to do so. I understand too well what it is to be unjustly attacked. There are those upon whom I would take revenge if given the chance. I would stand by you, Severin. I don't believe in increasing the power of Avedon more than I have to, and yet we do need to hunt down those who would hunt us. I mean, they're brigands, for Pete's sake. Can you stop being so self-centered? They're breaking the law in other ways than just attacking Avedon. Hello? they do deserve their fate. Dying, that is. Cahill has to die. Well said, Simplicity, spoken like a true hand of Avedon. I will be honored to have you by my side in the hunt. First, we should speak with Mirth. That debtbound might be more willing to tell us what we need. To know if he has to face multiple hands instead of just one. And one that looks, oh yeah, he's gonna be the party, blah 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 blah. Goodbye, Shima. We'll see about your equipment later. Oh hey, Shima's higher level than the Jerkface. Yeah. Not by much, like 670 points, basically. Okay, Sevlin, because it clicked there and I was the one to pop up, and that's just wrong. Shouldn't have been me. It's fine though. Everything's fine. I don't know whose stuff I just picked up, but I did. Debban Kva, do you have something to say? Not really, but she didn't have a particular name, so I did not expect her to have anything to say. There are more people in here than I expected. Well, if there's anything valuable, I can't take it, so let's just not bother. Mert. Hello. Another hand comes. Yeah, you speak for you, indeed. There's an old man sitting in this chair, staring into the fire. He's trying to simply blend into the background, but you know that all of the other people here constantly look to him, hoping for advice or guidance. When you approach him, he regretfully rises to greet you. Mert the Deadbound. It is unfortunate that you have come here. I hope that you will depart soon and leave us to our shame. You're not gonna get me to do so. You know the best way to get me to leave? Give me what I want. So anyway, let's be civil and learn about things. It is what you see, a group of people, poor and desperate, keeping close together in hope for safety. We are lost and prefer to be left alone in our shame. Whatever you want. We have no leader, none of us are worthy of commanding, and the others, even others as low as ourselves, however, my many years here have caused my words to be greeted with respect. Good for you, I guess. Over 30 years, I've long since given up hope of returning to the respect of the Kvar. Instead, I live here and do what I can for other unfortunates. He helped them out instead of helping you out? Noble, I suppose. The Deadbound and all who face shame in the eyes of the Stone Code. Criminals? No, or when they do, we turn them out. We take those who are shamed by debt, slander, or other causes. There are ways to run afoul of the Stone Code without committing a crime. That's a silly... what? Victims of slander have to run away in shame? That's justice for you? I don't get it. Of course, it brings stability and safety to our lives. It is not the fault of the code that I took on the depths that drove me here. It only declared the just punishment for my failings. Well, I mean, I guess. You're not here for slander, so, you know. Anything I can do? There's only one thing you can do for us, Saint of Avalon. He's going to say leave. Leave. Leave us to our privacy and our shame. Yeah. I called it! It's fine, though. I mean, my character would be the type to ask for pay before she does anything. I would still take the quest because I know that quest is experience, experience is power, but if you're role-playing as that character, that person, like, experience isn't really a concept. Like, in a sense, yes, but not really. What is a Deadbound? It is what it looks like. It is one who owes money and cannot repay it. The Stone Code declares punishment for those who fail to pay their debts. The Kvar has many colonies like this one. The Deadbound can then come here to be safe while they decide what to do. Stone Code in its wisdom gives several choices: repayment, temporary absolute servitude, or shameful exile. Repayment, yeah, I assume the rules for repaying are better fleshed out than just pay it back! Do it! Now! Because that would be silly. This is such a colony for the shamed. Of course, in Hulkland, those two lost and dead tend to be killed. In Darum, those in debt are enslaved. Same in Calamdari, although the slaves are fed better food. Life is harsh here, but it could be worse. The fact that it's, like, permanent slavery is terrible. You know? But whatever. Maybe the code could try to quantify. This much means this much time. Of course, you'd have to adjust it constantly because the value of money and so of debt would vary over time. So I don't know. It's complicated, and I'm not sure why I'm trying to think that through. Not long. Sometimes they find a way to earn money to pay back the debt. Others find this life harsh and choose solitude. Most only last here a few years before they choose a new path. None here have lasted as long as me. Why, then? My debt is too large. My shame too great. Also, I have a life here helping those who are lost. It is hard, but satisfying. Here I will remain. Here I will die. I have other questions, by the way. Important ones. Mert is not surprised by this most unwelcome question. The other Deadbound grows silent, everyone is grim. Someone asks, we will not answer. You ask, we still will not answer. I ask you, please go. Do not hunt the Claw. The Claw. That is what he is called. His hand is burnt and twisted. Why? Because Cahill does us no harm, and I fear that he will have revenge on us for betraying him. Also, the presence of the Claw scares away those who would take advantage of our weakness. That's not good enough. We are low creatures, but we have done nothing to deserve this. Please, I implore you, do not make us betray Cahill. I don't know if I can find him on my own. I would trust myself to find him on my own, except this is a video game, and if it wants you to hit a certain trigger to find something, it will make you hit a certain trigger to find something. So, gonna be a jerk because I don't care. We lose our safety and our protector. We have no choice. There is a hidden trail by all of the barrels. The path leads to him. There's a lot. That is all I know. There, now you have all. Leave us. Just, I don't know. They're still break-ins. They're not attacking you because you're poor. They're attacking everybody else, though. Like, that doesn't make it right. I get that, they're slightly safer because he's around, but that's not a good enough reason to not stop the brigands. I don't know what barrels he was talking about, though. That could be a problem here, eh? His inventory is still gonna be completely full, isn't it? What time is it? Kinda time for me to end it. I would have 4 minutes, but whatever. Next time, I'm gonna search for barrels, I guess. Were there barrels? It's surrounded by. Oh, wait, here maybe? Are those the barrels you're talking about? Maybe. Aha! We found the lair! Next time, we're gonna deal with Cahill. And probably explore the rest of this place, because maybe there's gonna be interesting stuff. Who knows? Until then, see y'all.